here from hippievanman.com. As you can see, today we're at Santa Cruz Surf and Skate, NHS Inc., which is a surf and skateboard company based out of Santa Cruz, California. So today we're going to talk to Matt. Matt is a surf pro here, and he's going to tell us a little bit about the company, give us a look around the headquarters, and yeah.
Salva Witch Doctor. These are like all these graphics you see here from the 80s. Super old school. This is half of our sales department.
They're
constantly in the road. Getting orders out the door.
Yeah.
Getting it going. Center where we make sure everything's ordered and purchasing, and then they, you know, get samples from our, you know, from the, our factories, and they have to approve them. If something's off, they go, hey, this color's not on,
yeah,
or this isn't right, and they just make sure everything's correct before we do our mass ordering, you know. Everything's smooth on the property.
Yeah.
You know, and the toilet's leaking. You know, it's like, oh, I got that.
It's a big job.
Calls the dude up, get the light up. And, marketing.
Cool.
So, yeah, marketing, indie, Santa Cruz teaser. This is apparel. They do,
you know, get gear and
clothing samples,
yeah.
All that.
Sweet. Do you have in-house designers, or you outsource for that?
These are, yeah, these
oh, here's your...
The girl back there, they're licensing, so they're doing licensing, yeah. Stuff. But she's, they work on samples and shit. And
cool.
They size everything. And web department, they do a lot of our video stuff. Work on a lot of our websites because we have so many websites for all the brands,
yeah.
And then they do some marketing stuff too, and
sweet.
We give them requests, they link it all together. It's, without these guys, I don't know what we do. Seriously.
Manufacturing or walking.
Wow.
We close at 4 o'clock, so they're about to close. The warehouse is closed at 4. But basically, do print t-shirts all day long. Yeah, probably. Right now, you know what? We used to print every skateboard had one color, right? You had to do it on a screen, and you had to, once that one screen was done, you had seven colors. You had to get another screen with the other colors, you know? It took days to do 1,000 boards. One graphic. It took so long, like weeks. Now we got heat transfers. Oh. So you got this plastic sheet with all the graphic already on it. You put it on the board, and back there there's these two wheels, these soft wheels, and it heats up to about 400 degrees or something like that. You put the skateboard on it and the graphic on top, and it goes through the wheel. The fucking graphic's already on there. Excuse my language.
It's
all
good.
Heat transfer.
But the heat transfer is like, it makes it quicker soon enough. Rupees grip tape. We used to do this in probably like the 90s, I'd say. It sucked. It kind of like graphic came off, or like the grip wasn't as
good.
But now we got a mob grip tape, which is a lot better. The grip is the best. These little things right here, they look like nipples or like boobies, you know? These little boobies, they dip down in the color, right? And this thing will go around and it'll put a graphic on it. Wish I had it. Weed grinders.
Weed grinders, perfect.
Right? Weed grinder? But this is our it does wheels. Yeah. It prints the wheels.
Cool.
But it's upside down though.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Never go wrong.
Never go wrong with boobies.
Okay, so NHS is the founder of Santa Cruz Skateboards, independent skateboard trucks, and a few other brands, Speed Wheels, OJs, just a road rider. But NHS stands for Novak Hout Sherman. Rich Novak is the owner. Doug Hout, he's Hout Surfboards, who's been shaping surfboards for like 52 years or something like that. And then Jay Sherman was, they were all three, or like they were all best buds through the 70s and 60s. And Jay passed away from leukemia in 1978, I think it was. When they were all doing surfboard stuff and all that, like Rich, I think Rich Novak ran the whole fiberglass in all California when Grubby Clark had the blanks. So Grubby ran the blanks, surfboard blanks. Rich ran the fiberglass. They worked together to go, hey, let's hook up this guy, but don't hook up that guy. You know, they kind of ran the whole thing in California for surfboard manufacturing in the 60s and 70s. When that started getting slow, Rich had all this extra fiberglass material, so he started doing skateboards in that, like 1973, I want to say. And that was the year they made the first Santa Cruz skateboards, in 1973. So they did the skateboards, you know, those little tiny skinny ones, little wood ones with, you know, fiberglass and resin on them. And then people liked them. One of our reps till today, one of Novak's good friends is Jimmy, oh shit. It'll come in a minute. Jimmy Hoffman, he's in Hawaii. He was the one that ordered the first bunch of boards because a bunch of the guys in Hawaii wanted them. They said, let's get a pallet over here. So they sent a pallet of skateboards with all the excessive supplies they had to Hawaii, and he sold them, bam. And then they knew they were onto something. So he just said, let's do skateboard shit. Hal said, I'm gonna, I think he stayed with it for a little bit, but he kind of went, I'm going and I'm doing surfboards. So Novak, well, I'm gonna do skateboards. When he made Novak, when he really started taking off, is when they made the clay wheels, and when they went from clay to urethane, right? And that's when like Cadillac wheels came out or something like that, and Road Rider. And Rich went and got a bunch of Road Riders, and he was in a van just like yours.
Yeah.
And he traveled around America and made his first $1 million by selling the Road Rider wheel, the urethane, right? And it's bungee, you could go over rocks instead of hit them and fly and get beat up, you know. So they started that going, and ever since then, that was the beginning. But from there, the 70s, it just took off, and I think it really started going big in like the mid 80s. Santa Cruz really took off, and we had really good team of riders, you know, from Steve Alba, Christian Hosoi, Rob Roskopf, Jeff Kendall. Just a lot of really good skateboarders, and I think the team pretty much helped with good wood, you know, good boards. And there was three brands in the 80s that really killed it. It was like Vision, Pal Peralta, and Santa Cruz. They were the three main skateboard brands, just crushing it. And then like sometime in the late 80s somewhere, team riders were going, fuck, I'm only making this much, and going, well, that guy's got making way more, the owner, right? So I'm gonna make my own brand. And people started branching off and making their own brands. And now it just kind of flooded the whole market. There's probably about, who knows how many skateboard brands out there now. So many skateboard companies, it's just kind of like, it's hard to compete with. I mean, there's been times where we had lows in like the early 90s. We had real, real hard times, you know. But we stuck with it. We focused, we regrouped, and came out stronger. And we're still here after 40 years. This is our 40th year anniversary this year, 2013. So very stoked to be part of this whole program. And Santa Cruz is awesome, independent.
How long have you been on board?
I've been here for 18 years. Yeah, just out of high school. We had a bunch of ramps here. You were saying about ramps. We had the Manson ramp, which was think a 6 foot half pipe height, 40 feet wide, like an elbow fin, so it had a killer hip in it and killer corners and extension. And this is the fucking sickest half pipe. And then we had a street course as well. And I'd come in, go surf in the morning, come in at lunchtime and, you know, kick a nug to the guy, kick the guy a nug, the skate, and I'd sweep up, do whatever I could to skate it and showed respect and pay my dues, and they just were cool with me, and I kind of had it in. And when it got busy in summer, they're like, dude, we need you to work. And I was like, fuck, dude, I'm like 20 years old. I didn't want to work. I just wanted to surf and skate every day. And basically, he's like, dude, we need you to work in. And I'm like, okay. So I started folding t-shirts and then shrink wrapping skateboards and doing all the little knickknacks and manufacturing and assembly and, you know, putting together so many skateboards where my fingers are bleeding and shit from the grip tape. So after the whole manufacturing production department, I went to shipping and I was shipping the product out, and I just fucking bust my ass. And then from there I started doing warranty, because the guy doing warranty needed some help at the time. And when he quit, I just took over the whole warranty gig. And I must have fixed 200 to 300 snowboards, Santa Cruz snowboards, throughout a 5-6 year period. Guys would send their board back and they'd like hit a rock and I'd be like, fuck, this is impact damage.
Yeah.
But I didn't want to leave in the cold. I'd just go bust out the resin and clean it all up, fix their board, give it a nice tune, send it back to them with a t-shirt saying, here, bro, fix your board. Even though it was impact damage, and they're like, fuck, how can you complain? Your board's rideable when you get it back. So unless it was something that you couldn't fix and it was a legit manufacturing defect, it's like, here's a new board, hope you're stoked. But the warranty gig was pretty cool, man. Kids would come in with broken trucks, broken skateboards, and it was just like, how do you turn down the local groms? You gotta take care of them. So I'd hook them up, and then everywhere I go around town, I'd hear like, Matt, what? Some kid like, look at my skate, I still got it. I'm like, right on. Pretty cool.
It's awesome.
And yeah, it's cool. The product coming out now is pretty rad. It's pop out boards, but we do make a lot of customs as well for our team, and they're made right here in the States, from Santa Cruz to Hawaii. And we also have guys in Australia making boards, and Brazil and other places. So, you know, it's mainly just for like team guys, but we can make customs for people out there if they want, and made right here out of Santa Cruz. Yeah, Santa Cruz is pretty rad. I love the surfboard program, so pretty cool times. I got to travel with it and enjoy a lot of trade shows and meet a lot of cool people and within the industry. But good times for sure. Yeah.